I think cutting-edge science has always meant crossing the line. I think cutting-edge physics has always meant crossing the line. High-end climbing has always meant crossing the line. And successful line crossing is an art form. Be it in science or be it in sport. I think this is the art of the dreamer, be it in science or in sport, who is also a doer, expressing himself and his own humanity in a new discovery, or why not in a challenging route up on an 8,000 meter peak. The commitment to this art, the art of crossing the line of what is possible or what it is commonly accepted as, I don't know, maybe ordinary knowledge is not the best word, can take you to one of the most intimate journeys that you as a human being can undertake. I believe that having the chance for even for a short glimpse over the edge, okay, even for a passing second, it is the privilege, it is a huge privilege of a very few. But getting beyond of what is known or what is commonly accepted as being possible most often means also stretching yourself to the maximum psychologically and physically. And even more, all this cannot be achieved without really taking significant risks. In a way, this art is the art of managing risks. But you will wonder, why bother of getting yourself cornered in such an extreme way? As the French writer René Dumont put it, what is above knows what is below, but what is below does not know what is above. One climbs, one sees. One descends, one sees no longer, but one has seen. There is an art of conducting yourself in the lower region by the memory of what one saw high up. When one can no longer see, one at least still knows. Or as I used to say, and I like to say, for me, climbing mountains outside is climbing mountains inside. Congratulations for being unsuccessful in getting yourself killed. This is what my partner and friend, Tunç Bindik from Turkey, told me the moment I arrived in base camp after my ascent of Shishapan, my nose, remained into my brain from them. I think I'm a very, very unreasonable man. I'm very unreasonable when it comes, sorry for my small unreasonable when it comes down to my dream, when it comes down to the project I get involved into with, and when it comes down to the expectations I set about myself. There are 14 summits in the world crossing the magic line of 8,000 meters elevation. All of these are in the Central Asia, in the border regions of Nepal, Tibet, China, India, and Pakistan. And as a comparison, these summits are for climbers who are, let's say, a Grand Slam tournament, it is for a tennis player. Imagine that the oxygen concentration in the air at 8,000 meters is only one third from the one we encounter in this conference room in Mongolia. I like to say Mongolia because I haven't been here for a long time. The most dangerous of all of them is considered one Nepalese called Annapurna, who has a fatality rate of 41%. This is nowadays, before the 90s, this was, before the 90s, this was 66%, so quite huge. Most of these ascents are still done using the supplementary oxygen and Sherpa support. And when I'm saying most of this, I'm saying more than 95% will not pose you any significant challenge to attain it. More than likely, your project or your goal or whatever you are working with, it is really not challenging enough, and maybe it's really not worth your time. This is one of the things that really fascinates me most at making ascent at 8,000 meters without using supplementary oxygen and without using Sherpa support. With all the planning in the world, with all the training, with all the sponsors in the world, it is simply not possible for you to know that you will succeed. So many can happen in the thin air of high altitude. Of course, it doesn't mean that you don't have the faith getting the job done, let's say, in a very pragmatical way. But it just means that the project is so complex and so challenging that the outcome, it will remain open till the end. It was one line before here, the previous presentation, saying something like that significant research is always improbable, or the outcome is improbable, something like that. I think that significant adventures, with or without the common, are always having an improbable outcome.